Hello, all you fellow gamers out there. My name is GamerLCD, and welcome back. I know I haven't made a video in a little while. I've been really busy. I went out of state for a little bit, but I am back, and I've got a special treat for you guys today. I'm going to be showing you guys a brand new game in the Halo series called Halo Spartan Assault, and it's available exclusively for Windows 8 platforms and Windows Phone 8. So if you have a Windows 8 PC, a Windows 8 tablet such as the Surface, go ahead and download this game from the App Store. And it is Xbox Live enabled. It has achievements, leaderboard support, and all that good stuff. And again, you can only get this for Windows Phone 8 and Windows 8 PC and tablets. There is one thing I should mention, though, about the Windows Phone version. It's only available for Verizon customers right now who have Windows phones, but it will be made available for Sprint, AT&T, and T-Mobile users in August. Late August, I should mention. But for right now, I am playing the Windows 8 version on my laptop. So what I'm going to do here, this is my first time playing this game. So what I'm going to do here is play through the first 15 minutes and give you guys a first glimpse of the game, and then I'll turn it off and I'm going to play through the whole thing. If you guys want more videos of this game from me, just go ahead and let me know. But for now, let's actually just dive in here. And again, like I said, I haven't played through this at all yet. Loading up records for don't know the controls or anything. And as with all my gameplay videos, I usually skip all the cutscenes and things, so I don't ask to not spoil anything for you guys if you want to pick this game up for yourselves, but for now, we're just going to go ahead and skip things. Let's see what we got here. Select Operation Umbra. The Northern Exterior version is covered in skin calls with the UNC, conducted a number of research projects while they were standard, blah, 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 blah. I'll let you guys read through that later. Select. Let's see. Upgrade your loadout and set skulls to increase your XP income. Man, we'll skip through this. Press space or left click the mouse button to continue. Alright. So this is a third-person top-down shooter, and if you're playing this on a tablet or a Windows phone, this is going to be fully touchscreen enabled. But my laptop is not touchscreen, so I'm using, of course, WASD and my mouse. Survive the Covenant invasion. Left click is to shoot my assault rifle. Right click is grenades. Shift is to switch weapons. Right now I'm back on my assault rifle, so let's switch over to the pistol. Since this is a third-person top-down shooter, I don't think I have the ability to zoom in. Oh my goodness, pistol's terrible. Let's go ahead and pick up. Doesn't seem there's a reload option. Can't actually check the options from here. I don't want to throw a grenade, no! How do I pick up that weapon? I pushed Q and I deployed some type of shield.
Completed objective.
Oh snap, this game is actually pretty cool. My bullet isn't traveling far enough. Die! There we go. How do I pick up weapons? Achievement unlocked. Recruit. And again, this is Xbox Live enabled, so you will be earning real achievements for your Xbox Live gamer score. Apparently I finished the mission. Triple kill. A one. I think there's 26 missions in this game. Loadout, armor ability, regen field. Ooh, I can purchase things. Drop weapons have less ammo. Enemies are more challenging. I'm not gonna put any skulls on. I'm a big wimp. What does buy credits mean? Ooh, real money. Ooh, my goodness. I gotta earn CR. I'm not gonna spend real money. Alright, so let's just continue through the game. Ooh, no load times. That's pretty cool. I still wish I freaking knew how to pick up weapons and stuff. Okay, melee is spacebar apparently. Alright. Not seeing a way to pick up weapons. Nope. Wait, maybe it's control. Nope. I should mention that this game is very, very, I wouldn't say simplistic, but it has a lot of elements that you wouldn't expect, such as being able to ride vehicles and things like that. And it does have its own unique storyline, and it connects through Halo 4, so that's pretty cool as well. There's no sprint option. Die. Bam. Ha ha ha. Triple kill. I'm almost at it. What do I do if I run out of ammo? What does this do? Go to the main menu after this mission to figure out how to freaking pick up weapons. Pushing a bunch of buttons is gonna help me at this point. Is there a map? No map. It's also important to mention that if you buy this game on your Windows phone, you will not be able to re-download it on your PC and vice versa. That's because they're basically different platforms. But if you do buy this on your PC, you will be able to use it on your tablet. So tablet and PC versions are interchangeable. Windows phone versions and PC versions are not. There's a pause button in the bottom. That's weak. I need to find a way to pick up a weapon, guys. This is not funny anymore. Not funny at all. Let's see. Whoa! Plasma myself. Okay, I picked something up. How'd I do that? It was either T or R.
I see him.
Let's see. It's E. It's E, guys. We got it. Alright. There's no... You can't charge the plasma pistol. Beast. Alright. Plasma grenades. Reach the extraction point. What's that? Oh, it's a shield. Or, looks like a clone? Yeah, it's a clone. So, looks like this game has everything you expect from a Halo game in terms of weapons, armor, and stuff like that. Get out of the way, bruh.
Mission accomplished.
All right. I think I would have much more fun playing this game on a tablet or my phone, to be honest, because of the touchscreen controls. Which is probably what I'll end up doing. I'm actually considering getting a Surface Pro. If you guys don't know, I actually bought a Surface RT. You can find my reviews for that in my channel, or just type it in Surface RT review. It should be one of the first ones that pops up on YouTube. So, but yeah, I think I'll play one more act for you guys, or one more mission anyways, and we'll say goodbye. 1000 XP. Oh, okay, sniper rifle. Can't afford that. Wait a minute, let's go secondary. Oh. What's a booster? Shield booster. Let's buy that. Bam. I don't know what that does, but it was worth buying, I think. Alright. Now, I was gonna avoid talking about this, but I don't think I can. You're probably thinking that, why are they making this exclusively for Windows 8 and Windows Phone 8? Well, as you guys know, Halo is owned by Microsoft, and Halo games have always been on Xbox consoles, so I really don't think that they would ever bring this to Android or iOS, or any other platform for that. Personally, I've been saying this for months and months now, that Windows 8 is not a bad OS. People took one look at it and said, what's with all this new Metro UI? I'll never use that. Well, the fact of the matter is, nobody actually does use it unless they're on a touchscreen interface. Like, for a Surface tablet or a touchscreen laptop, it's absolutely amazing. If you're on a desktop PC, you don't have to use the Metro UI at all, but you will get all the benefits of the Metro UI if you do so desire to use it. Not only that, but you also get like a lot of performance boosts. For me, I saw about a 19% boost to my performance when I upgraded to Windows 8. Not only that, if you're on a laptop, you also get battery performance increase. Windows 7 drains your battery like crazy, and Windows 8 is very, very kind to your laptop when it comes to battery life. So keep that in mind as well. I know everyone who hated Windows 8 said, I'll never use Windows 8. And when they actually tried it, they're like, oh man, this is the best thing to ever happen to me. It's so easy. I'm not here to ram Windows 8 down your throats, but it's just, I really, really love it. And once this comes to my Windows phone, I'm on AT&T, so I don't have access to it yet. But when it comes to my Windows phone, I will be purchasing that on that as well. Feels weird not having a reload button.
Oh no, I can't die!
I figured out why I screwed up when the last time I tried to do this mission. I was killing my own tanks, which is not good. Alright, I'm gonna try this one more time. I don't wanna bore you guys. Alright, let's do this. Let's go with the Wolverines for the defensive positions.
Let's do it!
What's this? Is that a shotgun? No.
Yeah, nice work, dog.
Get out of here. Graphics on this game are actually surprisingly good. I'm pretty sure they're gonna be even more special on a phone. Because of the condensed resolutions. And I found out there's actually no graphical settings, even on the PC version of this. I checked the options, and unless I overlooked it, there were no graphical options or anything like that. You can't change the controls either. But you can look at them. Alright, what do I got out of this? Nope. I got ran over by my own dumb tank. Okay, guys, I'm gonna stop boring you now. I'm gonna go ahead and quit out of here. That is a really quick preview of the game, guys. I encourage you guys to check it out if you have a Windows 8 platform. One more thing about Windows 8 is that you can get it for free right now. Windows 8.1, the preview for 8.1. It's a major update that's coming out next month for the Windows 8 platform. A lot of major updates to it, including bringing back the start button for those guys who hated not having the start button. The game is $7.99, or not $7.99, it's $6.99 on Windows Marketplace right now. You can pick that up, plus tax, of course. You can use PayPal, credit cards, Microsoft points, you can do whatever to buy it. It's on the App Store. And that's all for this, guys. My name is GamerLCD. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. See ya.